Right now at 5, jurors in the David Camm murder trial hear from an ex-convict who says Camm confessed to him in prison. Good evening to you. I'm Rick Van Hoos.
I'm Vicki George. David Camm is accused of killing his wife and kids 13 years ago in their Georgetown home garage, but he was being tried at the Boone County Courthouse in Lebanon, Indiana.
WLKY's Marissa Alter is live from there with the wrap-up of today's testimony. Marissa.
Rick, we expected to hear today from Charles Bonnet's girlfriend at the time of the murders. That testimony has now been postponed. But a jailhouse informant took the stand and said that in 2002, David Camm told him how and why he killed his family. Since September 28, 2000, David Camm has had the same story. He didn't murder his wife, Kim, and kids, Brad and Jill. In 2002, a Floyd County jury convicted Camm. The verdict was later overturned, but before then, Camm met Jeremy Bullock in prison. Bullock was a tattoo artist serving a murder sentence. On Thursday, he told the court he gave Camm a tattoo behind bars, and during that time, Camm admitted he shot and killed his family. Bullock explained Camm planned the murders during his Thursday basketball game so he'd have an alibi, but left to kill in between games. Bullock said the motive was marital problems. But Camm exclusively sat down with WLKY leading up to his third trial and said his family life was perfect.
I think that at that point our marriage was stronger than it had ever been. A lot of the changes that were made, and specifically my life, was for the benefit of our family. So I think it's a misrepresentation to say that there were issues within our marriage at all.
On cross, defense attorney Richard Cammon stated Bullock got moved to a lower security prison right after testifying against Camm at the second trial and later got out of prison early. Cammon also pointed out Bullock said Camm alone killed his family. The prosecution's theory is he had help from Charles Bonnet, who was already convicted in the Camm family murders.
I have no comment. Have a good morning, though.
Bonnet's girlfriend at the time, Mala Singh Mattingly, was supposed to take the stand Thursday, but there was a bit of a surprise. New evidence, a written statement Mattingly gave to police in 2005, was discovered. Neither side knew about the statement, and it wasn't turned over in discovery before Camm's 2006 trial.
I don't want to get into what, I don't know why it wasn't. It's pretty inexplicable to me.
Now, both sides wanted to take the weekend to review that statement before Mattingly takes the stand. That will now likely happen Tuesday, since there's no court here in this case tomorrow or Monday. The prosecution says it hopes to rest late next week. Reporting live in Lebanon tonight, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.
Thank you, Marissa. In 2002, a Floyd County jury convicted Camm. The Indiana Court of Appeals then threw that verdict out in 2004 due to improper evidence. A jury in Warrick County also found Camm guilty in 2006. The state Supreme Court overturned that conviction for the same reason.